You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Linder, your host, and I have a regular, regular person. I don't know what to say. I'm gonna get with the program today. Some regular guest.
Regular guest.
Paul Engel. Good to see you, Paul.
Good to see you, Mark.
Always good things happening at the library.
Yes. September coming up.
September is coming up. We're still in fall until either the 20th or the 21st. I never know which date that is, but. So we have stuff going on every week. We have stuff going on multiple times, like a three-part series. Mm-hmm. What's the first thing we want to promote?
First thing we want to promote, time for the classes. College and career sessions. We're working in partnership with the American Student Alliance. We started that the end of before the summer, and we're picking that up with career sessions for students who are looking at getting into college or getting into careers. And they're happening every Thursday from 2 to 4 p.m. in the main library.
Well, college and careers. College isn't for everybody. Mm-hmm. There's plenty of good careers out there, trade, school-wise,
Absolutely.
Things like that. Obviously things like nursing and stuff, which does require some college, but it also doesn't. You could do, like at Southeastern, you can do a LPN program. Yep. And then we have our own Massasoit here. So
That's right.
People need good college and career sessions. Let me tell you why. When I went for my master's degree, I got a Master of Science in Media Management. Mm-hmm. Had I gotten a Master of Fine Arts, I would have been able to be a full professor because it's considered a terminal degree. So you absolutely have to get the best advice. And if you have people like this, and it's free.
Yeah, and it's free.
You can't go wrong. Yeah. So advising is very important for people because college is very costly and people can spend a lot of money. And
don't I know it?
Yeah, you know it. You have a master's too.
Yep.
So let's switch to little kids.
Little kids. So we're bringing back playing with purpose. So these are sessions. They're happening, four of them are happening on the Fridays of September in the morning in their children's room. And there are four little tykes from birth to 6 years old, 5 years old, 6 years old.
Okay.
And they're just, it's a play group. It's getting kids engaged in tactile and sensory issues.
With purposes. And doing that in partnership with Coordinated Family and Community Engagement of Brockton.
Exactly.
It's good to have partners.
It is.
Library has a lot of community partners, and we all do a good job at the library, the staff and everybody, yourself, but to have partners from outside of the community that are tied in and connected in other ways, they're more kid experience. We have wonderful staff in the children's room, but to have a partnership like that, that's like
partnerships are everything. They really
okay,
are.
Okay, cool. And then this one I have a feeling is probably going to be food connected. What do you think?
Celebrating Hispanic Heritage Day? Absolutely. Yeah. There'll be food there, I'm sure.
Okay.
The Lease does a good job of getting the local community involved and getting food brought in from various groups. Vicente's is a big sponsor of ours in the library. Mm-hmm. We thank them every time we have their food. It's great.
So Saturday the 7th, 1 to 4.
Yep.
1 to 4, I'll probably be 1 to 4:30 because
4:30,
that group is the Latina Women's Association involved, probably.
You know,
Inez Figueroa, I'm pretty sure she is because I saw her the other day.
Yeah, I think they are.
We were having the Saturday-Sunday debate. I said the library's not open on Sunday, so it's got to be Saturday,
right.
And I will definitely be there because the last one I recorded, phenomenal.
Yeah.
The food was phenomenal. The program was phenomenal.
Yes.
The dancer, it was really good.
Yeah.
And that's the week after all the busy stuff starts, right?
Right.
So I'm looking forward to that one myself. So the next one is art and basketball? Help me out.
The Thomas, I don't know how to pronounce his name.
Dahlborg,
thank you.
Yeah.
In the Driscoll Gallery, he's an author of a book called The Big Kid and Basketball, and he's going to be talking about lessons he's learned in his life through coaching and through playing sports. A very inspirational topic, a very inspirational story that he has to share.
I mean, we're chock full of dates here. That's
Monday
the 9th, 4 to 5:30, and that would probably make for good TV too, so we'll have to check into that.
Yeah.
Maybe we can do that. But coaching is really important because if you adopt a philosophy that you're a coach rather than a critic.
Yeah.
Coaching is a different way of teaching.
Mm-hmm.
So
Absolutely.
Coaching, what you learn sportsmanship has a lot to do with how you treat other people in life.
Very,
so
very
that,
true.
I'm interested in that myself. Okay, so next up we have music.
Yes.
You and I have been talking about this for a long time, and it's become a music center too.
That's
so
right.
Tell us who this
Sergei Novikov is a world-renowned classical pianist, and he's going to be performing in our art gallery on the 12th, which is a Tuesday in the afternoon. I'm looking forward to that one. That's the first concert we're doing. We're going to be doing a lot more. The symphony's coming back in October.
Okay.
And I'm lining up people I know from my past at Berklee, and we're going to have a lot of great music this year.
We got the 3-minute cue, so I'm
going to.
But just let me ask you one thing. In terms of a classical piano, we don't have a piano on the third floor.
No,
the
he's going to bring his digital piano.
Okay, so everything's digital.
I'm still working on finding that nice piano. I haven't landed one yet, but I'm still working.
I got a few ideas for you. We'll talk.
Okay,
we got two more events three more events.
Yep.
So let's kind of go through them
quick.
I heard about this one at the NAACP meeting the other day. Dr. Karima Lewis,
mm-hmm.
and she's going to talk about 400 years of American Black history.
Yes.
A three-part series.
Part one is this, the 16th of September.
7 to 9.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's a nighttime program.
Nighttime program, yeah. That's going to be interesting.
Okay. And after that, we got back to Everyone Has a Voice,
that's
1
right.
to 3, Saturday the 21st in the afternoon. I didn't do well with poetry in high school, but you know what? I really enjoy it. And
yeah.
Philip Hosoris does a great job. Ali Brioso, who's involved mm-hmm. now and helped me promote it. Tell us who we have. I can't read the small print. You have the glasses on.
Jean Danny Jacquim is going to be coming back. He's been here several times for Philip. And he's the resident at the First Church in Cambridge. And then we have a young woman from Brockton High who will be our student feature. And I'm
going to try it.
Sure.
Misu Yorvina Fofana.
That's better than I would have done.
Okay. Well, I always say you do it phonetically, although it may not be phonetically. I could have totally botched it. And it has an open mic.
Open mic.
Featuring you.
That's right.
Okay. And last but not least, we have Tuesday, September 4th. Tell us about that, because that's kind of a big deal.
Yeah. My good buddy Ken Gloss will be in town Saturday, September 24th. Ken is the owner of Brattle Books in Boston.
Mm-hmm.
He's a book antiquarian, and I've used Ken as an expert many times in my career as a librarian. I've had him appraise collections. I've had him look at the value of stuff, and he's great. He's a wonderful guy, and I'm sure that his lecture will be something to hear, especially for book enthusiasts like yourself.
Exactly. So we start off the month with the Playing with a Purpose and the college admissions. We got early part of the month, Hispanic Heritage Day. Then we have the author, Big Kid in Basketball, the 9th, the classical pianist on the 12th, conversations with Dr. Karima Lewis starting the 16th, and two more dates, and September 21st, Everyone Has a Voice, and Ken Gloss on the 24th. So that takes care of September.
September.
And by the time we get to the 24th, we'll have you back.
Nice.
We'll talk about October and Halloween.
Yeah.
So the traditional stuff that we talk about, the website and the phone number.
www.brocktonpubliclibrary.org, and its number is 508-580-7890.
And they'll hear your voice when they call and figure out where they're going to which department and whatever. So I know the pointing has been finished.
Yes.
You guys are going to do the stairs in the front.
The stairs are done too.
They're done. Okay, I didn't know
next
that.
Next up is
and
the sign.
The next thing up is the renaming of the main branch, the Brockton Public Library, Thomas P. Kennedy Jr. Main Branch.
Yes.
Thanks, Paul.
Thank you, Mark.
You're watching Greater Brockton. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.